Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Morehead State Eagles and the West Virginia Mountaineers.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
Nick, if you were coaching either one of these teams, what would your points of emphasis be?
First off, an offensive attack, which is balanced, and all players are equipped to score, is very difficult to defend. Secondly, manage fatigue. Everyone makes silly mistakes when they are tired. Lastly, block out and make sure you're playing physically in the paint. Make sure you own the glass.
Well, here we go. The Eagles win possession and they're up and running. On the outside. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Trying to pack it inside. Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop. Takes the ball with a goal. Scoring.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. They're working around the perimeter.
Had a little trap really well there, Brian.
Number 22 gets the ball. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds left on the shot clock.
Dump it inside.
It's a big shot. The Mountaineers are considered pretty balanced, I think, when talking about their style of play. Wouldn't you say, Dick?
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court. Up and inside!
He shoots the jumper. They get it to go. Number 22 handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. Ten seconds left on the shot clock. Perfectly executed. They're working around the arc. Kicks off the lazy pass. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have...
He rejects it. Up and in.
Number 35.
Moving it around the perimeter. Intercepted. The point guard gets the ball. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
The power forward gets the ball. The ball goes out of bounds.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Cross court. Here's a nice face-up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
For two, perfectly executed. The shooting guard gets the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Turnaround jumper.
Nice rebound.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
On the dribble, gives it up. The 10 on the shot clock. Tries for two. The lay-in. The Eagles like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
Half-court teams really have to help one another. They got to set screens, move the basketball, get some dribble penetration. But most of all, shot selection is a must.
Gave it up. For the bucket, up and in. The center with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. With lots of room. He misses badly on that three-point attempt. Looking for a good shot. Ten on the shot clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the outside. Another turnover.
We're not talking apple turnovers either.
They're working around the perimeter. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Looks at the three. Not this time.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Goes up for two. The lay-in. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass. If substitutions aren't made in the near future, I can guarantee you that there will be some missed shots and silly mistakes.
Up and in. Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases. I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot. Great composure to pass it, despite the trap, Brad.
They work the perimeter. Tries one from three-point land. He shows the sweet touch. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Eagles. Coaching staff is comfortable with the current pacing of this game. They feel that the total number of possessions have to be kept to a minimum. This means extended offensive possessions and tough defense. If they can sustain this style of play, the chances of them winning is more likely. Guys?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper grabs the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Fed the low block for two. Perfectly executed. Working it around the perimeter. Pull-up jumper, left side. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore, Dick. That 10, 12-foot shot.
Yeah, the medium-range shot is an extension.
The power forward with the ball. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
He takes the rebound. To get it to the inside. He takes the open jumper. He misses from beyond the arc. With a long bomb. Going to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. The land. Take a look at this highlight, courtesy of Pontiac. Both teams looking to get things going here. The shooting guard gets the ball. Oh, yes.
Trying to go inside.
Dribbles around the trap.
Right around the trap. He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. Didn't realize my partner was a high-riser. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket, number 35 with the foul. First personal foul. Number 11 coming in for the first time tonight.
He will give this defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Erin Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team, providing that additional insight. Gets his first action tonight, Dick.
You ask me, Brad, this kid could easily be a starter.
Inside. He gets the rejection.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Here's the three ball. The Mountaineers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
The shooting guard gets the pass. Gave it up. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the dribble, gives it up. He launches a three. Goes. For a shot. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Now on the run.
Good score out of transition, baby.
On the outside. Turnaround jumper. Way off target. They work it around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. They just can't seem to miss.
They found a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it. Dump it inside.
Open shot. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
There's a slam.
Up and inside.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. Looking for a good shot.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad.
The small forward receives the pass. Cross court. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Grabs it.
Now they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Dick, look at this highlight. A strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
That's a fantastic play, Brad. That's definitely a candidate for the Pontiac game-changing performance.
The small forward takes the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. Wide, wide open. And nice looking jumper in the lane.
Number 42.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Number 10 makes his debut into the game.
I'll tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to break it.
Up and in. Defense taking away any open looks. No. Now the rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Number 4 receives the ball.
That spacing.
Lots of room. And come up short. Pushes it up. Shoots. No good from the field.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
The power forward gets the pass. Looking for a good shot. Three. The Mountaineers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brad, he's on fire.
The power forward takes the pass on the outside. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Gave it up. The jumper. The Mountaineers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
At the end of the first half, these teams are all even.
Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. In terms of those points of emphasis, Dick, what do you see so far?
I think these guys really need to rethink what they're doing. The points I brought up earlier should put them in a position to win games. If they stray from those points, they'll have a tough time winning on a regular basis.
Thanks, Mr. Vitale. We'll see how they adjust their style of play for the second half. West Virginia has hit a ton of three-pointers in this first half, Dick.
And if you ask me, Brad, I think that was the difference in the first half.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. On the dribble, gives it up. He takes the wide open shot. Dick, they are on a deadly tear right now outside the yard.
Everyone's in on the action tonight, baby.
The shooting guard with the ball for two. The Eagles have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
The center handles the pass. They go into the low block for the bucket. Perfectly executed.
escape the trap.
They work it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper. He brings it down.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
For the bucket, the layup. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries for two. Number one is called for the foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I think, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
He goes to the line for the first time. First one is good. Second shot, no good. They work the perimeter. He goes with a baby hook.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Great job of dribbling around that trap.
Great job of beating the trap there, Brad.
The power forward with the ball. Cross court. 10 on the shot clock. Goes up for two. With the layup. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ten on the shot clock. The small forward receives the pass. Goes up for two. The layup is good. Working it around the perimeter. Jumped in front to take it away. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Gave it up. And the ball goes out of bounds. Sideline inbounds. on the dribble, gives it up. Picked off. They're off into transition.
Terrific score off the fast break. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Number four takes the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. Now the turnaround jumper. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
On the outside. Here comes the ball screen.
Great pass out of the trap, Rob.
Ten seconds left on the shot clock. That spin move not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting.
He blocks the shot. Number 21 handles the feed. They work it around the perimeter. Great defense. Now they work it around the perimeter. Intercepted. Eludes the trap there.
Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
Tries for two. They are red hot right now.
They're feeling it from everybody on the floor, Brad. They're getting it from every spot on the court.
Well, I think it's time for some subs, Dick. The player fatigue is really setting in.
Inside.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He pulls down the board.
Up and inside.
And the ball goes out of play. Number 22, quickly checking back in.
They need him out there, Brad, just like I need you, man. This guy is the glue.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad, as you can imagine, I am seeing a completely different attitude on the bench now than I did in the first half. The coaching staff and players, they just have looks of disbelief on their faces.
Thanks, Aaron. Time out on the floor. We'll have a little break in the action here, partner, while both teams talk it over. To the action now in the half court. Let's see what they set up, Dick. Looking for a good shot. Picked off.
He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. With a rejection, the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vital, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the top of the circle. Comes up empty. Moving it around the perimeter. The Mountaineers are one of my favorites because of their recent success. You know, it's always great to see a team go from ordinary Joe to extraordinary.
It's the story of evolution. Evolution of a college basketball program.
He goes to the line for the first time. He hits the first. Nothing but rim. The perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
With all sorts of time, he rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious. Look at that spacing.
Pressure's getting to him. The Eagles have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
The small forward gets the pass. For the deuce. Was that beautiful or what? Looking for a good shot. Goes up with it. Busts the J. This looks like it might be a rout.
Hey, the defense better force some turnovers.
On the outside. He puts up the tray. He comes up empty. Up and in. Number five takes the pass. For two. Lays it up. Can their defense get them back in the game, Dick?
I tell you, it's going to be a long hike back, Brad.
The small forward receives the ball. Gave it up.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
Trying to feed the low block. The lay-in. Number 34 with the ball. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. Tickles a twine. The small forward gets the ball.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Eludes the trap there. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
jumper. He misses the jumper. The Eagles are the type of team who would like to slow it down, Dick.
They need to slow things down, Brad. I don't believe their coach wants them to play at an up-tempo pace.
The point guard takes the feed. Goes up for two. Two with a lay-in. The Mountaineers are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
At this point, playing in the half court would be a wise move. They don't really need to score, but do need for time to come off the clock.
They work the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I'll tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Shoots from the outside. It won't fall. Pushes it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. And a big rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
The point guard with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Let's it fly. No good from the field. Working it around the perimeter. He's fine to charge.
Great court savvy by the youngster.
Dick, to you, what are the numbers saying in terms of bench scoring here?
Well, you know, Brad, really, when you think of good basketball teams, they're usually teams that are strong when they have strong 6th, 7th, and 8th men on their roster. They fare much better than other clubs. Quite often a Sixth Man of the Year award will go to a team that goes deep into tournament play.
He blocks the shot. Number three is charged. They get it inside and a chance for a three-point play as they score. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Eludes the trap there. Timeout. What mindset, Dick, do coaches want their players to have when they leave a timeout?
Well, for me, Brad, I wanted my players to have a clear understanding of what the objectives were for the upcoming possessions. Timeouts are a great way to get your team back on track and a way to really alter the tempo of the game. Great coaches have a knack for calling timeouts at the right times.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Coach was obviously very fired up in that last timeout. I'm sure his excitement and enthusiasm was felt by his players, but can they channel the enthusiasm in the right way? I think that's what's going to be most important for the next little while, guys.
Well, nobody said it was going to be easy, did they, Dick? Coaching, that is.
I sure hope not. A lot of sleepless nights coaching a basketball team. The expectation to win consistently, not win occasionally, but to win consistently. Winning consistently is one that stresses out a lot of coaches. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Tries for two.
They let him get into a rhythm.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He looks for the bomb. The shot won't fall. How effective will this zone be if they start hitting the J's, Dick?
Well, if they start knocking down a few, it'll really extend the zone.
And of course, whether they start hitting the J remains to be seen so far. Dumps it in. Goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving this building without a fight, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. Gave it up. He intercepts it. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Well, Dick, it really seems as though things are starting to heat up right now on the sidelines.
Hey, coaches hate to see their players underperform. Playing to their capabilities is important. He's going to stay on them all game to make sure everyone on the floor is playing as hard as they can play on every possession.
And let's go back out onto the floor. Dumps it in. And the ball goes out of bounds. So the pass will come in from the baseline. He's all alone.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
It's down to a one-point game, Dick.
Yes, sir. This is where the big boys start to play, Brad.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this point in the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And the clock stopped with a foul. That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I told you there was a lot of time, Brad.
And yet another foul. At the free throw line. Missed it. Pulls down the board.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Right now. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
The small forward receives the ball. They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brad?
If only my knees weren't aching. Maybe some game plan changes, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
Dumps it in. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
How many bricks have we seen? Will somebody make a jump shot, please?
Well, during pregame, we emphasize some points, and likewise in the half. Dick, now your final thoughts.
Well, Brad, the points of emphasis provide some valuable hints, suggestions, which can and should result in a better team performance. Achieving them may not always result in a win, but it does make winning more likely.
Teams are so diverse these days. They play all different styles, and it's a matter of knowing your personnel, primarily their strengths and weaknesses. Morehead State played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
Brad Nessler saying so long. For my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, thanks for joining us.